Hey boys and girls, Mike here, one go short play. There's a lot of the adventures of games happening now. This is the adventures of Dr. Franken on the NES. These are adventures of games. It looks like they're not going to stop for a while, which is kind of good, because adventures of games means action and adventure, and it's exactly what I've been asking for. Ooh, I wasn't expecting such a real, I'd say realistic, but a realistically stylized game. It's not very nice to play. Ow. Okay, I'm just working out what's what. You don't die. So, off we go. That's a horrible jump. Oh, it plays Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata. It's a bit of a cliche, but it's one of my favourite pieces of classical music. It might actually be my favourite piece of classical music. There are a few that I love. Chopin's Raindrops. Love that. When it goes all minor chords. Locked? What's locked? The stairs are locked? Don't be silly. Get down from there. Get down. Exit in the wall. This is all feeling a bit counterintuitive. I've got two buttons. I've got that, I've got that. I've got a start button and a select button. Okay, select button. Okay. I think that's where I am and that's where I want to be. Yeah, I think I love classical music with that kind of... I guess with the more morose to it. I don't at all. I love Beethoven's Eroica symphony as well. If you've never heard that, check it out. Ah, you pull down to symphony. Oh, right, okay, we're dealing with a 3D room. Let's bear that in mind. There was no sign that there was a door frame. You know, like Defenders of the Air, if anyone's ever played that, and you see the door frame in front of you, and you kind of get it, that you can come forward. I think people from Sirius on the Spectrum did the same thing. That's an awesome game, incidentally. Do check that out. Is it people from Sirius? That sounds right. We've got different levels of jump here. Yeah, the jump is as horrible as it looks. We've got that. That's if you tap it. That's if you press it. Oh, we've got one level of jump. That's always a bit sucky. And it's really hard to make an accurate jump because it's a set jump. It literally goes up, down, there. And... oh, that's nasty. That's nasty. This game is killed by its jumps, which is a shame because that music's amazing. Oh, I don't like him. The music really doesn't fit the game. I mean, it fits the atmosphere of the old house we're in here. But the little blue dude spouting fireworks from his mouth. And we've got Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata thing. There's a bit in the original Resident Evil, if I remember right. It might be just in the remake, but I think it's in the original. Where one of the NPCs, non-player characters, plays Moonlight Sonata on a piano. And I think it unlocks something. It's been a long time. I don't respawn on me. I've just been through all the trouble of getting rid of you. And you're back again. Okay. And I remember it was a beautiful moment. It was a really atmospheric moment for me. I didn't know what that song was at the time. I've since listened to Classic FM. we can go on that. Okay. And learned a bit about classical music. And yeah, just totally fell in love with this piece of music. I can listen to this all day. Especially on a piano. Not so much on a... what's that? That's a little green dude. They're very Bart versus the Space Mutants. Spider. Horrible spider monster. Can I see my map, please? Oh, hang on, I see that. That's a new place. Shoot them. I got a little frightened there. This is all Castlevania, isn't it? Can I have that off the wall? Funny enough. I like the lighting outside the window. That's very atmospheric. This game has its charms. It's just rarely that jump. What were you thinking? I just think we weren't particularly thinking, oh really? Too many dead ends. Oops, skeleton. Oh, right, we can't kill him, but we can jump over him. The platforms are a little weird as well. I mean, there's two levels to that window ledge. There's the front of it, and there's the back of it. What's that about? Just have one in the middle, that'll do. I mean, I know nitpicking, but that gets on my wick, because I've done my fair share of platform games, and it just feels like an amateurly designed platform sort of system there. Which means that it's not very well designed, which means that I'm taking hits because this game is not very well designed, which means that this game isn't fair or fun, which just kind of sucks. incidentally, it's not that it is. It's unfun. It's actually... I'm actually having a moderate 60% level of fun playing this, which is more than most games, to be fair. It's just not... There are much better games, you know. This feels very 8-bit era. And it is, but it feels very 8-bit era. Not like it. That was just suicide, right? Oh, bless me. Birthday sneezes? Yeah, it's still my birthday. That's why I'm playing video games in bed. You don't see this very often on YouTube, do you? Video games in bed, ladies and gentlemen. Video games in bed. Yeah, it feels very 8-bit era, you know, like sort of, well, I was going to say like Black Lamp, which I love, because again, it's got an ace piece of music, which is the Elizabethan Serenade. If you, excuse me, oh, it's all happening now. If you're into classical music, or you don't know what that is, check that out, that's amazing, amazing bit of music. It's very Christmassy in my book, although people say it's also very summery. On the toilet, oh, ow, ee. Elizabethan Serenades, another bit of classical music in a game. Frankie cannot read. Is he Frankenstein? Oh yeah, of course, this is Frankie's Revenge. Look at his head. They've clearly modelled him on the on the Universal Monsters version of him, which became a sort of trademark look for Frankenstein. The Frankenstein's monster. Let's get it right, Mike. You are the person who's just been watching Hammer Horrors all night for his birthday Eve treat. That was kind of cool. I think I mentioned that in my last video. These are done in a batch. You may have noticed. I think I'm going back on myself, but the book I picked up has got to be for something. This has got a little... I quite like this. It does have an 8-bit feel, as in sort of Spectrum games. Spectrum games for me. Games like... I might be testing the knowledge here. Or I might be just talking about games that no one plays. Games like King's Keep, which I've mentioned before on Spectrum Groups, is an amazing, underrated game, which I played with my mates when I was a kid, for nights on end in the summer, and between us we finally completed it. There's four of us around that game, my brother and two of my mates, Anthony and Ben. Then there was Scepter of Baghdad, which was another awesome game of this kind, where you run around picking up things and using other things, although I hadn't really used anything, I'd just run around aimlessly, finding doors that I didn't spot before. Is that a key? Imagine that. It is. What's four now? Yes! I open, let's go. I got a bit overexcited there, eh, didn't I? It's only a video game. Scepter of Baghdad was a good one. And then there's games like Blind Panic, which are more... that is a Martech game. It came with the awesome player, and it became an absolute classic with us for a while. And again, we beat it, even into the back room in Mum's house on the Spectrum, we beat it. This has got, these games have got, well, this game in particular has got shades of that era. It is a bit people from series. And you know what? Much as I hate the jump mechanic, that's pretty much all I hate about it. No, it's not. The fact that many of the cues, you know, like the exit, for example, that as an exit is not a good. That is not a good way of illustrating an exit. All right, it does face you when you stand next to it, so it's kind of there. But there seems to be some early 8-bit era amateurish errors in this game. Nothing to hate about that. In fact, that's a charm, if anything. And the platforms aren't very well laid out. Oh, look. I think I'm building thingy, aren't I? Bride of Frankenstein or something. They've got their lore from Universal Monster movies. And it's a little bit off here and there, but it's good. It's good. Now, that last game I played, that Hudson one, I grew to hate as I played it. Thingy Ricky, whatever it was called. Dinosaur Ricky. This one, something like that. This one, I'm growing to love as a player. Alright, I'm playing really badly, and I'm running into everybody in the game, but, you know, you get to know the levels as you go along. And I'm not really playing it properly. I'm just playing it to get a feel for it. See what it's like, you know. And I, you know, I quite like it. But I've got this feeling I'm running out of time. So, that to me was actually better than the last one. I'm so lucky. I really enjoyed that. I grew to like it. It's a grower. Dr. Franken on the NES. It's a grower. Thanks for watching.